As another example where control and data plane separation comes in handy, let's look at the security of internet backbones, where filtering attack traffic is a regular network management task. Suppose that an attacker is sending lots of traffic towards a victim. In this case, a measurement system might detect the attack, identify the entry point, and a controller, such as the RCP, might install what is called a null route to ensure that no more traffic reaches the victim from the attacker. Two fundamental challenges with SDN are scalability and consistency. In an SDN, a single control element might be responsible for many forwarding elements. So a control element might be responsible for hundreds to thousands of switches. Of course, for redundancy and reliability, typically we want to replicate the controller. So while the controller is logically centralized, physically there may be many replicas. And in such a deployment scenario, we need to ensure that different controller replicas see the same view of the network so that they make consistent decisions when they're installing state in the data plane. A final challenge that's also worth mentioning is security or robustness. In particular, we want to make sure that the network continues to function correctly in the event that a controller replica fails or is compromised.